Well, they had to shut down the streets of West Hollywood last night as diva Diana Ross met towering transvestite RuPaul. ET's Lisa Canning was there for an event that was part drag pageant, part street party, and all Hollywood.
She is the diva queen of Motown. He is the drag queen of pop. And last night, Diana Ross and RuPaul gave Hollywood a royal treat when they joined together to make a new video of an old hit.
We just took I Will Survive into the 90s.
Well, how did you hook up with RuPaul? That's what I want to know about.
We met at the airport the first time, but I think we've just known of each other for many years.
For RuPaul, it was a dream come true when his longtime idol approached him about making the video.
I've always been in love with Diana Ross. When I was growing up, I studied her album covers for my makeup tips.
Who would have ever thought in a million years you'd see me and Diana Ross together on Santa Monica Boulevard?
By no means is this your typical music video. The streets are blocked off, and it's not just the traffic that's a drag.
Hello, E.T. Welcome to the party!
The casting call went out for some unusual extras, and Hollywood responded. At times, it was difficult to tell the real Miss Ross from the imposters. When you see this kind of love, I mean, what do you feel like? What goes through your mind?
It's a beautiful compliment.
I have Ross.
Well, Rue No More, as promised, here they are, remaking Gloria Gaynor's I Will Survive.
See you tomorrow.
Bye-bye.
I know how to love, I know I'll stay alive. I got all my life to live, I got all my love to give.
Well, there's a lot of competition out there. You know what I'm saying.
Well, I tell you, you know, and this song is about that. It's about, there's room for everybody. There's enough love to go for everybody. And I think Diana Ross is the epitome of self-love and saying, you can do it, I will survive. I'm the boss, I'm coming out, it's my turn.
Welcome back. Welcome back from the break. Did you miss me? Yeah! Oh, you're just saying that. Okay, now on VH1, I'd like to pay tribute to a lady who's very close to my heart. She's been an inspiration and a guide throughout my whole life. You know, this here is the introduction I've been waiting to give my whole life. Really, I love this person. In fact, she's had more number one hit singles than any other person in history. She's the mother of five beautiful children, and I'm proud and delighted to have been invited to join her on her latest video, I Will Survive. So before we bring her out, let's roll a clip of us on the set of I Will Survive.
Well, the title of the song is I Will Survive. It's a remake. It's a Gloria Gaynor song, and it has become, over these years, every generation, just like an anthem.
It's also the fact that Diana is an international icon who is a survivor and who has come from point A and gone to point zillionaire, you know.
I will always make my music. As long as you'll hear me, I'll sing. And even when you don't want to listen, I'll still be singing. Would female music be different without me? I don't know. Yes.
You know, without Diana Ross, I don't think I'd be standing here today. I tell you, because she gave me the bus token it took to get here, okay? No, really, I love her, and she's just everything to me. And she's here with us right now. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the one, the only, Diana Ross. It's like Vegas. Here, you sit here.
I sit here. Okay.
I know your left Hello. Side is your best side, isn't it?
This one.
How you doing?
I'm well. Good.
Now, you just flew in to be with us today.
Yeah, came to be with you.
Oh, you're so sweet.
Yeah.
You know, you have such
big energy. That's the first thing I related to first time I saw you. Are you spiritual?
Yes.
You are?
I am. You mean you spotted that?
Oh, absolutely.
I don't know if that's exactly where all the energy comes from, and I'm sure it is. Mm-hmm. But I think it's just that I like the work and I like being here. You know, it's a good life. It's good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, the new album, Take Me Higher, I think is fantastic. I think it's probably one of your best albums.
I love it.
Now, what made you decide to remake I Will Survive?
Well, I don't know. It had come to me quite some time ago. And I mentioned it to the then CEO of Motown, which was Gerald Busby. And he said, you know, I don't know. You know, you've survived. I don't know if people will get that that's really, you know. And I went like, this message is a message for all people. You know, it's such a special message about, and I think everybody needs it right now, you know, to know that you can go through adversity. And, you know, if you continue to believe in yourself that you, and also your words are so important. You keep saying, I will survive, I'll mm-hmm, get over, I'll mm-hmm. manage, I'll do it. And, you know, I think it works. And so I wanted to do it. I was in the studio with Narda, and I said to him, you know, I'd like to remake I Will Survive. He said, you want to do it? Baby, let's take this into the 90s.
And, you know, it really belongs in your repertoire with songs like I'm Coming Out, It's My Turn, and yes. Ain't No Mountain High Enough. It really belongs there. And with that, actually, guys, we're going to show the video, so let's cut to the video, okay?
Okay, I'd like that.
Great.
First I was afraid, I was petrified. Kept thinking I could never live without you by my side. Then I spent so many nights thinking how you did me wrong. And I grew strong and I learned how to get along. And so who tried to break me with goodbye.
That is just wonderful. It's a great deal.
Oh, you guys, if you had been there, Rue was out there on the stage telling everybody, get out there and buy this record. This is the best record you got. You know? And as soon as the cameras would go off, he was organizing, you know, everything, making sure everybody was in shape there. It was really lovely.
I had a great time. It was just the best. And just being with you was the best part. What was the best part of the video for you?
Well, you know, all of it was. Mm-hmm. Being there with all my lookalikes.
Yes.
You look better than me, you know? It was wonderful. People don't believe that that's me at the end jumping out into the audience.
Right.
You know, and it tickles me because I think I did that. I was the beginning of jumping in the audience. Years ago in Paris, I went to a big gay club in Paris. And all the guys picked me up and put me on the bar there. And we were dancing, I don't know to what song. And then all of a sudden, I just flew out into the audience. And not only did I fly out there, but they carried me around the room. It's just like I was levitating. They were just moving me around the room. So that was the first time I did that, was years ago. And it requires a lot of trust. You got to know that the audience really loves you and is there for you. I mean, you can't just pop out there now, boom, on the ground. I thought you were going to jump out there with me
God,
next.
Oh, God, not me, honey. My hair would fly that way and I would go this way.
In London, they played the video over and over and over again and tried to get close up because they could not believe that was me.
Yeah. You know?
Because I took my dive that, you know, like a swimming dive, you know. Like,
God, you know, I wish you had made so many more movies. I saw Out of Darkness, and that is... Oh, God, a tour de force acting job. Are you planning to do more movies?
You know, there's a big article in, I don't know if it's Time or Newsweek. It's really about, it's really hard for blacks to get that door open up. I mean, you know, it's like token things that happen a little bit, you know, as far as the film business. I work really hard trying to get movies made. And I must say that the financing is really difficult to do.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm still working on projects now. I'm working on one called Diva.
Ooh. You mean like
I'm not a diva. I know some divas.
What about directing? Would you ever direct?
Yeah, I'd like that. I would like to do the normal process of, you know, you're learning. If you learn how to be an actress and then you want to move to the next step, you know, just take a step and take a challenge. I would hate it if I've lived my life and not gotten an opportunity to do all the things that I've dreamed of. So that's what I Will Survive and all my songs are about. It's like, go for your dreams. You know, you take the next step. You may not manage. You may not get to there where you'd like to get, but if you even get close, at least you've taken an opportunity to do the things you want to do in your life. So I tell everybody I'm with, go for your dreams, you know, and you can make it happen, whatever they are. But don't just sit there and think it's going to come to you, because you got to make it happen.
Absolutely.
You know, you have to make it happen.
Absolutely. And I have to say too that I picked that message up from you from day one. I saw you on the Ed Sullivan Show. I said, the one in the middle there. I thought the other two girls were great, but the one in the middle, she just wanted to perform and entertain and please everybody so much. Teeth, there's like 200 teeth showing and just going for it, you know? I love that, and that's what I relate to.
The truth is, you know, the money and all, if you do the things you love, the money and the success and all that will follow if you continue to do the things you love. I tell my kids that, you know, and I guess that's why they're staying in show business and not studying to be doctors and lawyers.
Now, when I saw your concert at Radio City Music Hall, and you had your kids up on stage.
Yes.
In fact, Rhonda sang and she sounded wonderful. And then one of the boys, I don't know which one, was up on stage dancing.
The 7-year-old, Evan. Evan.
Is he the dancer?
Yes. Evan is not shy and he loves to dance. And
he was like doing
the Tootsie Roll.
The Tootsie Roll.
Yeah.
Now, can you show me how to do the Tootsie Roll?
Girl, I can't do that.
Yes, you can. Come on. You want to see her help me do it? Okay, come on. Show me do it. We'll go to a commercial with you showing me how. Okay,
roll the tape. Now we need the audience to get up and dance with us.
Oh, yeah? Okay. How do you do that now?